But there's a lot of, you know, I'll miss the joyous times, you know, the time spent that Kylie and I used to spend watching our favorite show together, you know, things like that. Howdy, howdy, folks. Thanks for joining me today on Travel Talk. I am in the car parked on the highway. They are doing road work up ahead. And I'm late for my eye exam. I've already called them and let them know I'm sitting here waiting. I'm going in for my final eye exam after my surgeries. Well, maybe not my final one, but hopefully my final one. If all goes well, it'll be my final one. And he will check to see if I need glasses. My eyesight's pretty good. I'm light sensitive, but I've been that way for a long time. But my eyesight's pretty good, and I think maybe it can be improved with glasses. I don't know. He's the expert. I can see up close. I can see. Although I do know that reading, the readers do help me. So, I may just need readers, and if I need prescription glasses, then I'll just use my old frames, because the frames are very expensive, and, gosh darn, these glasses these days are just out. You gotta take out a mortgage. I mean, serious. Okay, we got some movement on the other side, so I wonder now. They're letting the other side go. We're down to a one lane here on the highway. And my lane is stopped and the other lane just started moving. So hopefully we'll get to moving here pretty soon. The road's being redone, which is necessary. But I sure hope to goodness that they get my road done off the highway I'm on. My goodness. That highway, that road is tore up. So I guess they just determine on traffic on, you know, which roads come first. But it's good to see the roads being done. It's shame on me for not leaving earlier. I've already called them. They'll know I'll be late, but I hate being late. But anyway, that it is what it is. So I know I have been a little bit absent. Okay, here we go. I've been a little bit absent on the channel, and that's because we've been going through some home changes. You know, changes. Embrace the change. Well, you know, against my better judgment and my, I don't know if you really say my better judgment, but against my desires, Kylie has decided to move out. She is out of the house now. She has found a house in town that she is sharing with two other people, one of which is her boyfriend. She has decided that she wanted to, you know, more independence. And, you know, Kylie is a very independent gal. And they're both working full time. And so they can make the bills. I just really hated to see her rush so quickly into this type of a situation. But, you know, she's 18, and her boyfriend is 18, Ozzy. He's 18. He's a fine young man, so far, what I know of him. He has signed up for the Marines, so it's on a delayed entry. So he'll be leaving for boot camp next year. Now, Ozzy has one more year of high school, and although he's 18, He does have one more year of high school because he and his twin brother were held back one year in the younger elementary grades, in the real young elementary grades. So one of them got held back, so mom held them both back, which I can understand. I can definitely understand. I don't know who, you know, as far as the details go, I don't know who got held back or anything. But she says since one is remaining back one year, both of you, because they're identical twins. So, and even if they weren't identical, I mean, I would surely understand that. You wouldn't want, yeah, no, that wouldn't work for me either. So anyway, he's a Marine. He just hasn't entered into the Marines yet, although he has signed. He has signed his life over to the Marines starting next year, and he would like to get married now. And I'm glad Kylie is waiting a little bit. And I think what they're doing is they're waiting to see how this relationship progresses. Well, I think Kylie is waiting to see how this relationship progresses and just exactly how well they get along over the next year, right? How things go. Because it's a fairly young relationship. And although it's against my, I begged, pleaded, and did everything I could to get her to stay home, she wanted to do this. So, you know, I love her anyway. You know, she went ahead and moved out. I support my children. It's not the most ideal situation in my opinion, but, you know, they got to figure things out on their own. And she's a level-headed kid. And so my best goes to them. But that leaves me, for the first time in my life, living alone. And facing this empty nest syndrome thing that people talk about. Now, I'm fine. I'm fine with it. I'm not feeling any kind of whatever it is that you want to call it that people go through with an empty nest. Now, so far so good. But, you know, because I've been a caregiver my entire life I have been a caregiver, first to my siblings, my younger sisters, and then, you know, once I got out of the house and got married at 16, started having kids at 18, there you have it. It never ended. It never ended for me. So this is actually the first time that I am footloose and fancy free and responsible for nobody but myself. And nobody even being in the house with me. Now, I do have my dogs, okay? I do have my animals. I am still giving care to them. But I'm going to see what happens, you know. I'm gonna see where this goes and how I feel about it and things like that. I'm sure there'll be some days of adjustment, and I'm sure that I'll be fine. So Brittany and Colin are still there on the property, and they have their acre in the back. And Colin right now, in fact, is in Arizona because his mother flew him home. He's coming back on Saturday. He left yesterday, which was Monday. He's coming back on Saturday because his uncle is dying of cancer. And he's had cancer. He's been fighting it for a while. And I guess that it's getting very close to his him leaving this earth. So his mom bought a ticket and asked him to come home. Not only Colin, but his sister, and, you know, the siblings and stuff. Everybody's going to be there, I guess, to say goodbye, I guess. I don't know a lot of the detail. If he's in hospice, I'm not sure about all this. But all I know is that he's in Arizona going through that grief with his family, because he was very he's very close to his cousins and his uncle and his aunt. You know, they're a close-knit family. So my heart goes out to their family, to his family, and to Colin. And we certainly understand that pain. So Brittany's there, and she's hanging out with me. Last night she stayed over in the house, and because I told her if she's lonely or anything, because, you know, she's young, right? To feel free to come on over and hang out and stay the night, things like that. So she was over last night, and I don't know if she'll be over tonight. We'll see how she feels. Oh my goodness, pardon me. We'll see how she feels, and of course she's always more than welcome. So we got a whole new life ahead. The whole change thing is coming on again. There's always, you know, always something going on. There's always changes when you have when you're alive. Things always change. And I'm ready to embrace it and see where it goes, and enjoy my solitude time. Enjoy my clean house. Once I get it cleaned, it's filthy. But keep myself busy on the homestead. I've been painting in the house, and I'm doing outside work, and, you know, just piddling along. Boy, we've had some hot weather, so I haven't been outside too much, but short time in the morning. And then, of course, we had a lot of rain before that. So we'll see what happens. We'll see how things go. And I'm going to go over there and see Kylie's new house today for the first time. I've seen pictures, but I haven't been over there yet. And so I'll go over there and see her and see Ace and little Chicken. She took Chicken and Ace. The other cats now, Nala and Ganji, are still with me. I don't know if she's going to take those. She says she is. But I told her she can leave them there, you know, because they're outside cats. So it's up to her. They're her cats. But they don't give me any grief because they're not in my house. So, but yeah, I've got some plans. I'm working on the house. I ordered new doors, bedroom doors, and the bathroom door. I'm replacing with new style doors. I'll try and record the work that goes along with hanging those new doors. I plan on trying to do it myself, so don't get mad at me if I don't, because a lot of times I just get right in there. I don't have the patience to film it all, but I can tell you about it and show you pictures. But, you know, Melanie and Anthony, gosh, and they, you know, they just do fabulous work, but with their, fabulous work with their editing and their filming. I just don't have the patience. I get right in there, I get it done, and then I don't want to have to think about it and mess with, you know, filming and editing and, you know. But anyway, so I did order new doors, and that's going to brighten up the hallway a lot, because those doors that are in there now are really dark brown stained doors. They're really the old style. They're flat front, flat, you know, they're flat on both sides. The doors I ordered are panel, you know, have six panels, right? Two small at the top, and then two, and then two. And so they're going to really update the look of the house. And then I'll be, of course, they're primered white, and I'll be able to paint them and have them look nice when I get to that hall section of painting. I've got the dining room and the living room walls all painted. Now, I haven't done any more because I haven't really hung a lot of stuff up or anything, because, you know, that paint, it ended up being flat paint. And if you watch the previous videos, you know, I talk about that whole nonsense. It had a lot to do with my eyesight. I really wasn't seeing well, and I didn't follow up and double check when I bought the paint, and I didn't make, I told them what I wanted, but I ended up getting flat instead of satin for that middle color, and I'm trying to decide if I want to repaint with satin, because flat is so hard to wash. You can't hardly wash flat. And I have animals. So I'm really leaning towards, gosh darn it, I'm really leaning towards going over it again with the satin finish. And that'll entail, you know, one big wall and two small walls. So that's going to be work. So that's why I really haven't hung too much up yet. And I'm not really, I've been contemplating, I've been living with it. I've been living with it since it's been done. And the more and more I look at it, and the more and more I live with it, the more and more I realize, you know, I'm going to have to do it right. Do it the way it was supposed to be done in the first place. And that's partially my fault, you know. It's just one of those things. Dadgummit, it's just one of those dadgum things. So, anyway, that's what's been going on, folks. I've been contemplating and dealing with Kylie's move, and trying to figure out, now I've got this spare room. Well, I have Dawn's room. I have a room set aside, which I call Dawn's room. That's the room she uses when she comes to stay. And then Kylie's room, which is the newly, freshly painted one that I just did. I'm contemplating that room, what I'm going to do with it. I think I want to pull the carpet up in that room and have some flooring put down. Because number one, the kitty cats, they ruin that carpet underneath the door. It's all ripped up, and I'm just so aggravated. So, you know, what are you going to do? Nala did that before Nala became an outside cat. She would put her paws underneath the door and meow and you know, scratch the underneath. And she ripped it up. And I kept telling Kylie to keep those cat caps on. And, of course, kids don't listen. You know, teenagers. They always have a reason why they can't do something that isn't necessary. So I'm not going to miss that. I'm not going to miss, you know, I'm certainly not going to miss the aggravation that comes with teenagers. But there's a lot of, you know, I'll miss the joyous times, you know, the time spent that Kylie and I used to spend watching our favorite show together, you know, things like that. I told Kylie, I said, well, now that you have a house, you can have Thanksgiving dinner. You can host dinner. Making a joke, of course. She piped right in there. She goes, yeah, I can, if I have enough room. And she would, too. She would. She may just do that. I don't know. But anyway, that's what's been going on, folks. And other than that, all is well. I've been, you know, there was, I had one day where I was really saddened, you know, and I was just shaking my head thinking, what am I going to do now? I mean, all I've ever done is take care of kids. So now, no kids. So, and I was really quiet, and I was contemplating, and I was thinking, and I just felt God speak to me. He says, Charlene, it's your time now. It's your time. It's your time to focus on you. And only you, you know. And not to worry. Not to worry. They're going to be okay. There's good, strong kids, all of them. And I know this is true. And I heard him, you know, just speak to me quietly. He says, look, you're not alone. I'm there with you. And it is your time to focus on you. And do what you want to do in life. So, with that, I was thinking, I got people to go. I got places to go and people to see. I see my sisters over in South Carolina. Probably take a trip over there. And, you know, as things as the times go by and the days go by, we realize, you know, life is short. Life is so short, and we have to make the best of every day. I am not going to sit at the house and feeling sorry for myself because I'm there alone. Not going to do it. Because I'm not alone. I'm not alone. And if you, if you're listening to this and you're thinking to yourself, you know, that you feel alone or you don't feel like the Lord is with you. Maybe you knew the Lord you're not as close as you feel you should be, or maybe once was. Or maybe you don't know the Lord. I want to encourage you to open up the scriptures. Start letting Him speak to you through His word, and He will. He will speak to you. He will make Himself known to you in a very mighty way. He will speak to you. He doesn't want anybody to live this life that we are given here on the earth. He doesn't want us to live separated from Him or from His love. And there's nothing we can do. The scriptures say nothing we can do that can separate us from the love of God. Isn't that amazing? Our whole life, any wrongs we've done, if we ask Him, He is faithful and He is just to forgive us of those wrongs and those sins, and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. And when you have that knowledge and that feeling and that know that you know that you know that you know that you've been forgiven and you're loved and He is working in your life and He wants to guide you and lead you and direct your steps, there's such peace in that. Being alone is not something that we face when we have the Lord. He is with us always. So, although this is a new experience for me, I'm embracing it, and I am excited about it, and I look forward to what good thing God has for me ahead, whatever that may be. He'll reveal it to me. It'll unfold as I seek Him. He'll unfold it to me, and it's going to be good. If it's from God, it's good. Because He has no harm in mind for any of His children. So, be blessed today. Thank you for joining me on this travel talk. It's not probably the most, you know, exciting one or whatever, but... So be blessed today and know that you're not alone, and know that the Lord loves you and that He cares for you. He laid down His life for you, and He wants to have a close and personal relationship with you. He wants Himself. He wants to be part of your life. And, all you have to do is say, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Be blessed. I'll see you next time on Travel Talk. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.